Hello, everyone. Movie recommendation for this Halloween season: The Conjuring, based on the true case files of the Warrens, and that would be Ed and Lorraine. They're real-life demonologists. Now, the effects in the movie are exaggerated, I'm sure. If you don't like scary movies, please don't watch it. It could be disturbing to some. I happen to like scary movies. I usually go for the B-rated ones because they're kind of funny too. The old ones back in the 70s and stuff like that. Yeah, there's some fun ones out there. Anyway. What's interesting about this movie is the Warrens, as they're teaching a class on demonology, talk about three steps to demonic possession. And I think the first one they said was invasion. I might have gotten that one wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's invasion. The second step is oppression, and the third step is possession. That's pretty close to describing what projective identification is. Yeah. When I first got married to the narc, and everything kept going wrong, it was him. He was doing it. He was moving people around like chess pieces and setting traps for me at every turn and using me like you wouldn't believe. And I had no idea. He was the last person I looked at. The only reason I started to figure this out was because, like I said, he admitted to getting me fired from my second job. Otherwise, I would have never guessed it was him. Until later on, when I started catching on, and he just didn't care anymore what I saw him doing and stuff like that. So, The Conjuring. It's a really good movie. Scary. So if that sort of stuff upsets you, don't watch it. But yeah, spiritual warfare. I thought about that quite a bit because that's what it's like. It really is. I try to remain objective, because after Vatican II and the Catholic Church tried to get away of what they called superstition, and tone down the exorcisms and things like that because of psychology. Psychology came in and explained away most of the things that were going on in people's heads and people's lives, so they thought. Yeah, I think they're doing more exorcisms than they've ever done, actually, now these days, to be honest. Yeah. And then it triggered the memory of being in the lawyer's office. When I first was going to NARC's lawyer for an agreed divorce, we were both going to use him because it was a simple process. And I agreed to meet with his lawyer. Recall, we're behind closed doors, and the lawyer goes three times, says, "My husband is Satan, my husband is Satan." He's not whispering, I mean, he's actually saying it, but in a really low voice, under his breath, and he's like growling it too. No kidding. The first two times he did it, I ignored him. I'm like, well, I don't know what's going on. I'm thinking this isn't happening. He's not really doing that, right? The third time he did it, I just went, okay, yeah, he's that too. Can we move on now? Right? And then that's when he got up in this big theater and he says, "You leave my office. You have 3 minutes to leave." And he opens the door and I'm going, and says, "You have to leave now." And I'm going, "What is going on?" Shook me up pretty bad, which was the idea, of course. Of course it was. I had no idea what I was walking into, obviously. Yeah, slimy, isn't it? Yeah, and that's the same lawyer that hires abuse victims. That's the same lawyer that offers him and his associates services to the social service agency. Pro bono, sometimes. Yeah. Yeah, crazy stuff. And I'm watching all this happen, and I'm trying to tell people. This is what's going on. You're letting it happen. But blind. They don't believe me. That's how discredited the narc made me. Yeah. But anyway, The Conjuring, like I said, if you don't like scary movies of this magnitude, don't watch it because it probably could be very triggering. But I looked at some of the work of Ed and Lorraine Warren over the years and stuff, and I think they're pretty legitimate. I really do. I was gonna say that I really haven't had any major ghostly experiences. I can name a couple, I think most people can, that couldn't be explained away necessarily. And then I was gonna say, I try to remain objective, you know, because there is psychology and all of that stuff can be explained away. But then again, there's my experience with the narcissist. Yeah. I was thinking about that. Spiritual warfare. So when some people talk about that, most certainly it applies to NPDs. There's no doubt about it, and psychopaths. Yeah. Would an exorcism help them, though? Not likely. No. That's why you got to get away from them. So maybe I have had a supernatural experience for the last 18 years, 23 years. I know what it's done to me. That's for sure. I know what it's done to my family. Yeah, and it's about as close to a horror movie in the suburbs as you can get. But anyway, I hope everyone's having a good day. Peace out.